Welcome back, awesome action toy fans and subscribers. I'm looking at a Takara Microman. This is Material Force, which is 1/18 scale blank figure. This is a female one, and it says Micro Lady Wegger Black, all in black blank figure. I'll be comparing this to some other blank figures as well to see how it compares to them. If you haven't subscribed already, please consider doing so, and also click on the notification icon to be updated when I get new videos, which is almost daily at the moment. And to let you know, I'm about a month and a half behind with the videos I publish. So literally it's like one or two a day, just to try and catch up. And I'm not going to catch up, so I just bought like this week, I don't know, about 20, 30 figures. So I'm a long way behind in catching up. But it's good for you guys. There's a constant flow of toys and videos. Okay, so let's open this up and have a look. I'm quite excited about this because the Microman stuff is generally quite good on the articulation. I'm trying to see if there's any way to open this without ripping the box too much. But let me see. Maybe if I slip the tape here. Will that be easier? Okay, there we go. Oh, I like it. Very easy to come out. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spare sets of hands. Give you a look there. You've got a fist slightly open, more open, 2 finger open with the fingers, and then with the thumb down like that. Pretty cool. They are peg in and all have this articulation. I think one set maybe doesn't have that articulation, or two sets. Have a look. One set has this articulation, it appears to be. Yeah, the more pistol hands, which is nice. Here is the figure. Lots of screws in the back is the first thing I notice. Appears to be quite small, but I can see great articulation already, which is very, very promising. Just push the wrist in a slightly better. Feet appear to be a bit big, so she stands up very easily. And the plastic is like a hard plastic, which I'm not so keen on. The other thing I noticed is that the pelvis section here is very loose. You can maybe even hear that, which is not a great start. Okay, so let's look. Just a plain black thing. In fact, it looks a bit like an Epoch Android from their Android Toy X. In fact, I'm going to pause this video, get one of those as well, so you can compare that as well. So I'll be back in 1 minute. Okay, I am back. So before I look at articulation, let's compare to an Epoch Android, Epoch capsule toy. You see that the capsule toy is far bigger. This is quite small. Similar because of the smooth, blank-looking head. Shoulder design is similar. Hips completely different. The body articulation is going to be the same, hips different, and they've got a thigh twist, which is not on here. Interesting, and this is double joints, this is a single joints, but very good articulation. We'll compare that in a moment. Okay, so she's quite small. She might be closer to a action Alpha Blanks figure, and I'll put that up there in terms of scale. Alpha Blanks are these really cool, and you know, quite cheap, about $8, I think. Blank figures you get from this very small company called Go Native Toys. That's a free shout out to them there. And they're about this sort of scale. They're 1/18, but they're on a small side, but it would scale really well with this. Okay, so let's look, and also I'll put this in the description of the videos here somewhere. Let's look at her articulation. So she has a left and a right, an up and a down, and she has a side to side. Shoulders, look at that. Apart from coming apart, that wasn't great. But shoulders go all the way up. Which I can't even do. Unless I bend my arms to there. Which is fantastic. And the joints are tight, even though that joint did come apart there. Let's get the arm around. That one came off as well then. In fact, I just put this arm on the wrong way. That's why it's quite tight now. Let's get that one. Oh, everything's coming apart in my hands. Not a great start to a video. Okay. But also, it's good to know that it does come apart, so it's easy to do to modify for customs and other stuff. Okay, so double elbow joint. So this should be like completely tight, I'm assuming. Yeah, look at that. Can even hold her head in our own palms. mean, my arms don't go that tight, and if I try, I like my arms stop here. You know, I've got to bring my chest in like that to hold my head. So she's really, really quite flexible. So these joints come apart and start to annoy me if it keeps happening. In fact, it's even more similar to the Epoch Android too. So very flexible there. There is a bicep twist. Wrists, you can see, do this and this. Very flexible. She has trunk forwards, trunk very far backwards, trunk side to side. She has a waist twist, which is very good. Okay, legs outwards. She gets quite far. Forwards should be good, very good forwards, but backwards the sculpt gets in the way. But it still is about a full, nearly a full split, because that forwards is just phenomenal. Look at that. She has a thigh twist, which is good, double kneecap and skinny legs. So that's like you can't get tighter than that. You know, I can't do that. It's really good, and the ankles are on a. Let's have a look. So she gets a tippy toe, just a hinge. She gets a really good Michael Jackson. Look at that. Woo! One of the best Michael Jacksons I've seen on the figure. They don't turn that way or that way, and they don't pivot like this. Pretty damn good articulation, to be fair. Okay, so. But she does keep coming apart at the shoulder and arm. And the hands will be easy to swap out too. They're just small, soft pegs. The hard plastic worries me. You don't want to drop this from very high. It's might break, you know. And they might deteriorate in the sun. So compared to this, it's very similar. He's only got a single elbow joint, but he can do almost the same poses. But he doesn't have hand joints. She's got much better articulation, but she's more expensive. And I looked in the box. I can't see the year this was made or manufactured, which is a shame. I'd like to know when. If I compare this to other blanks, you see that it's very different. So this is a Android. This next one is going to be a fake knockoff Boss Fight Studios blank figure, which I picked up without realizing it was fake until it opened it. But, sorry, until it arrived. So I only saw it online. But it's, you know, for all intents and purposes, identical to Boss Fight Studios, except the quality is lower. But it gives an idea, a better idea of scale. And it's female again. So you see that? Let's get this stand up first. See that the Microman one is considerably smaller. If I look at a Picado blank, this is like a chubby blank figure. Again, I'll put it in suggested videos. I do like this a lot. It doesn't come with a head. It's really quite cool, but it scales more closely in height. And last but not least, I look at I think it's Good Smile Company. I use the female blank. Which they do these blank figures, but they're supposed to be for making dolls, I believe. But they're actually perfect scale for 118, and they're fat figures again. See, it's really, it's on the female, that one. I should pick up the male, never mind, I used the male. And so you get this real nice variety in blank figures you can get in 118. You can find these blanks great for your customs. And these are very similar, though not identical to the, what's it, Picado one here. In fact, they're looking more similar, actually, for looking at them. In fact, they are identical looking at that there. Interesting. So one company's copied another. So you can see that we have, or rather, those are the two that are the same. My mistake, sorry. You can get the different one out here. This is a different one here. Okay. Yeah, this is different. Let's take that one away. We put this one up there. So this is a taller figure. You can see that we've got the four blanks there. I just put the Android there because it looks like a blank. And you can compare them. I'll put them closer to the camera so you can see. So this is the fake Boss Fight Studios, but it looks very authentic. This is the Microman one I'm doing now. This is the Good Smile Company, and this is the Picado or Picado. But I put all of these in the suggested videos. You can see that compared to normal 118, she is quite short, shorter and slightly taller than her. This is maybe about the same height if you put a head on there. But this will have the best articulation. I do like my blank figures purely because you get such good articulation. Let me rephrase that. Such good customization options. I'm not keen on all these screws in the back, but I do like the fact that you have lots of hands and it's easy to take a hand out, put in, and swap over and change. The hands, they're not tight enough. They're not rubbery, so you can't really put a gun in unless you change for a specific hand and you're lucky enough to have a gun handle that fits. Whereas these ones, like this one here, you can put a gun in. This one, you definitely have to change the hands, otherwise you've got no chance of getting a gun in there. Same with this one here. It is a great looking blank. Great articulation. Definitely worth picking up one if you can find one. I'm tempted to get a couple more, but it wasn't cheap because they're quite old and they are, again, Takara, which is a good, good brand. I'll tell you that there is a year, 2004, so these are, what, 15 years old, coming on 16 years old. It's a shame you can't find them easily anymore. Okay, this is Awesome Action Toys, and I'm signing out, saying please like, share, and subscribe. I'll be back to do more Awesome Action Toys videos for you. Stay happy and keep collecting, okay? Bye-bye.